There are certain, under normal circumstances, one shouldn't even socialise with a woman who's not your wife and not your relative.
High five to that again, because we're on the same page.
But
Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen.
That's what we believe. We believe that God cannot be tired. He's the all-knowing, the most powerful. So again, the concept of Jesus, God dying on the cross. Me and you reject that, right?
Yeah.
Okay, yeah. So I want to ask you another question. Like, for example, I'm intrigued. I'm asking this because I'm just intrigued. How does it work for you guys? Like, for example, me personally, I got married about 2 years ago, yeah? How does the marriage process work for us? Like, for us, it's very strict, yeah? So, for example, we can't go on dates, yeah? So it doesn't work. Like, if I want to get to know somebody, I have to go through the father. How does it work? Because I watched a documentary on this. But it is complicated.
Obviously, there are certain, under normal circumstances, one shouldn't even socialise with a woman who's not your wife and not your relative.
High five to that again, because we're on the same page.
But yeah. Obviously, you have to get married.
Yeah. And let's get a high five for the marriage.
you're not expected to marry a stranger.
Exactly.
And therefore, in the dating process, so normally, you would not be allowed to start... get pleasure from looking at a woman, for example.
Okay.
But if you're looking to get married, you go on a date, you are supposed to look at her because you've got to make sure you're comfortable with her.
But
she has to remain properly dressed. You can't see when she's not covered. You can't touch her.
Okay.
So there are certain things which become permitted when you're genuinely looking to get married, but there's also certain boundaries.
That's quite interesting.
So, for example, when it comes to touching, it's very interesting. At the beginning of the wedding ceremony, the groom places the veil on the bride.
So the groom places the veil on the bride?
Because he has to make sure that she's the right one. Before she's got the veil on her face, he makes sure that she's the right one.
Okay,
and, but at that point, you have to be very careful as he places the veil that they're not, that he doesn't touch her, because
okay.
At that point, they're not married yet.
So what happens if he accidentally touches her?
If it's an accident, that's another. He should try not to touch
her.
Okay. As they're on their way out of the ceremony, they come out holding hands.
Oh, okay, so
even when they're engaged, even when they're actually about to begin the wedding ceremony, they still don't touch.
Okay.
So in the dating process, there are certain leniences, but there's boundaries as well.
Okay, so that was very... Okay, so it's the same with us. So when you're getting to know the other person you're married, like you said before, you're not allowed to touch her, you know. So that's quite profound. That's what I was asking, because there's a lot of things that are in common as well. And also, another thing is, so when you do the contract, how does the marriage contract work? Do you read something of the Torah? How does it work? How's the marriage contract? Is it just you read something and then you say in the name of God?
No, there is a marriage contract.
Yeah.
It's actually written. It's written and signed by the groom before the ceremony.
Okay.
It's the witnesses who are going to witness the ceremony obviously have to make sure they witness beforehand that the groom has been through and understands everything. And that states obviously various terms and conditions of marriage rather.
Okay.
The contract doesn't affect the marriage. The marriage is affected with when the groom gives an item of value. It's usually a ring, but it can be anything of value. And so he says to her in Hebrew, You will be married to me with this ring in accordance with the law of Moses in Israel. And she takes it from him. She acquires the ring, and the witnesses have to watch that process.
How many witnesses?
Two.
That's quite interesting.
Wait, say by you?
The way you say it, I feel like you're talking about Islam. Yeah, it's two witnesses.
Anyway, so that's how the marriage is affected. The marriage contract doesn't create the marriage, but it creates terms and conditions. It's the man's commitment to the woman.
Okay.
Which is written in the contract and
okay, that's interesting. That's actually very common with Islam. It's very common. One other thing I was going to say is, if I'm not mistaken, once a year you guys prostrate.
Once a year. We prostrate once.
Once.
That's the first 2 days.
So is it how we prostrate?
I haven't seen you prostrate.
Like
But we can't put our face direct on the ground, so we put a cloth down in front of it.
Okay, so you cannot touch the ground.
Our face shouldn't touch the ground. So you put a cloth down and straight with your face on the cloth.
Okay.
So you do it once on the first 2 days, and then on the 10th day of the year is Yom Kippur, when you prostrate four times.
Oh, so then you prostrate four times?
On Yom Kippur.
Okay, do you know how we prostrate? Do you want to show you?
Do you want?
Is this how we prostrate? Yeah? So we're like this.
Yeah, it looks pretty much like that.
Our head, our nose, our hands, our knees and our feet have to touch the floor. Yeah?
Like that, but with us, we don't actually put our face on the floor directly. We put a cloth down and put our face on the
floor. So you put a cloth down?
Yeah.
Okay, that's similar. We have to pray five times a day, by the way.
We pray three times, but on the festivals...
You pray three times a day?
Every day. We face Jerusalem when we pray.
So you faced Jerusalem when you played?
Yeah.
Okay, we faced Mecca, but before the Prophet ﷺ would face Jerusalem. But then it got changed.
In this?
So when you, you know when you pray three times a day, do you have to do some kind of ablution?
Well,
is there any ritual that you have to do?
The standard thing is washing of the hands.
The hands, yeah.
There are some people who immerse their entire body in each morning in a special type of pool.
So what do you do? Like, what kind of prayer is it? Like?
Well, some of our prayers are recited standing, some of them are recited sitting.
Okay, that's interesting. Do you guys drink alcohol?
Yeah. But in moderation, yeah. You shouldn't get to the point where you're not in control of yourself.
Okay.
But if you keep within that limit, you're allowed to drink alcohol. Yeah.
Okay, that's interesting. I don't know if there's any questions that I want to ask. Is there anything you want to ask me? Yeah, guys, it's interesting. Just last question. The long black thing that you guys wear, or the hats that are...
The black furry hats?
Yeah, what is that? Do you have to? Is it like... Is that
no, that's done in certain communities. It's not universal.
It's like a symbol.
Okay. Obviously, some communities are more religious than others. Yeah. Some are stricter than others.
Personally, it was a pleasure, man. Thank you, man.
Go, please explain about the things.
This is put on in the morning.